Hello students, happy learning. In this video we are going to see fire insurance claims. Fire in the business premises of any firm can damage a number of assets like stock, building, furniture, etc. In addition, the normal working of the firm is affected for number of days or month, resulting in loss of sales and loss of profit. It is very difficult for the business to replace all destroyed assets and normalize its working without affecting its working capital position and cash position. During such a difficulties time, external helps is like a boon to the business. All business firm insure their stock and also other assets against risk of fire. They take appropriate insurance policy from a recognized insurance company by paying a required premium. This enables the business to lodge a claim against insurance company and receive sufficient fund to replace the loss of asset. Insurance company investigate any claim made through the experienced assessor. They evaluate and the cause for the fire and the actual loss through the damages. Based on the assessor's report, insurance company settle the claims made against it for loss due to fire. There are two type of fire insurance claim. One is loss of stock, another one is loss of profit. In this insurance claim, we are not going to see any journal entry. It's very easy. This lesson is very easy to understand. So here we are going to see how the claims are made by the company, and particularly we are going to see only loss of stock. So here in this loss of stock, there are four methods are involved. One is gross profit ratio is given in the problem. Gross profit ratio is not given in the problem. Another one is the average loss policy, and the last one is the abnormal loss. So there are four methods are involved in calculating the claim of fire insurance claim under loss of stock. So here, under the average loss policy, if stock on the date of fire is more than insured stock, average loss may be applied in computing the claim for loss of stock. It means your stock on the date of fire is more than insured stock. Insured stock means the policy amount. Okay, so your stock, the value as on the date of fire of your closing stock is more than the insured stock, then you have to apply average loss policy. Let's we see the problem. So here the fire is occurred in the premises of merchant on 15/6/89. A considerable part of the stock was destroyed. The value of stock saved was 4500. It means a salvage value is 4500. The books disclosed that on 1/4/89 the stock was valued at ₹36,750. The purchases up to the date of fire is 1,04,940, and the sales up to the date of fire is 1,56,500. On investigation, it was found that during the past 5 years, the average gross profit on sale was 36%. Calculate the claims to be made. Okay, so here this is the format. For insurance claim, you have to prepare the memorandum trading account up to the date of fire. Okay, usually you prepare the trading account for the year ended, whereas in case of insurance claim, you have to prepare memorandum trading account up to the date of fire. Okay, so here the fire is occurred on 15/6/89. So up to the date of 15/6/89, you are going to prepare memorandum trading account. Now, what is the first value is given? 4,500 rupees is the salvage value. So this is the format. So you have to prepare memorandum trading account and a statement of claim. So here the statement of claim is nothing but the closing stock on the date of fire minus the salvage value is equal to claims to be made or actual loss of stock. Just substitute the value. So what is the opening stock value is given? 36,750. Okay, opening stock. Purchases up to the date of fire is 1,04,940. Okay,
The next sales after the date of fire is 156,500. 156,500. The next gross profit is given 36% on sales. So 36% on sale. So 156,500 multiplied by 36%. The value comes to 56,340. 56,340. So now the closing stock. Okay. So 198,030 minus 156,500. The closing value, the balance equator is 41,530. So here 41,530. So now we have to prepare statement of claim. The closing stock value as on the date of fire is 41,530. The salvage value is given in the problem is 4,500. Okay. Now the claim to be made to the insurance company is 37,030 rupees. This is nothing but actual loss of stock. You see, you can see the next problem. A fire occurred on the premises 31-12-83. From the book which was saved from the fire, it was ascertained that sales from 1183 to 31-12-83. It means up to the date of fire is 12,80,000. So sales is 12,80,000. Okay. The next purchases 8,40,000. Purchases is 8,40,000. 8,40,000. The next opening stock is 2,36,000. 2,36,000. Now here the gross profit is a 35% of sales. So 35% on sale is 12,80,000 multiplied by 35%. The value is 4,48,000 rupees. So here the debit side total is 15,24,000. Here 12,80,000 rupees. So remaining balance is 2,44,000 is the value of closing stock as on the date of fire. Then you have to prepare the statement of claim. So closing stock on the date of fire is 2,44,000 rupees. The salvage value given in the problem is 30,000. So salvage value is 30,000. So the value of claims to be made is 2,14,000 rupees. So this is the actual loss on the date of fire. Our claim to be made to the insurance company is 2,14,000. Let's see another problem. In this problem, a fire occurred on 1993 in a godown of Mr. Ganesan. From the following particulars, find out the claims to be lodged. Stock. Opening stock, this is 1,193,000, 25,300. Then purchases up to the date of fire is 50,400. Sales up to the date of fire is 1,56,000 rupees. Manufacturing expenses and wages 60,000. Goods are taken by the proprietor at a cost 2,500. The rate of gross profit on cost, this is given, on cost is given. Profit on cost is given 30%. The value of salvage of stock is 3,600. Okay, now you substitute the values. So opening stock, what is the value? 25,300. 25,300. The next purchases up to the date of fire. Up to the date of fire is 50,400. Okay, sales up to the date of fire is 1,56,000 rupees. The next manufacturing expenses is 60,000. Manufacturing expenses 60,000. The next goods taken by the proprietor. Goods taken by the proprietor is 2,500. Then what is the value? Balance value 47,900. Okay, 47,900. The next rate of gross profit on cost is given. So on cost. So here cost plus profit is equal to selling price. It means 100 plus 30 is equal to 130. Okay. So cost plus profit is equal to selling price. Okay. Cost plus profit is equal to selling price. So now what you are going to do here, The sales is 1,56,000 rupees. Sales is 1,56,000 rupees. It means 1,56,000 divided by 130 multiplied by 30. You will get the profit. Okay, once again, I am telling the sale is 1,56,000 rupees. Okay, here gross profit is 30% on cost. It means 1,56,000 divided by 130 multiplied by 30. The profit is 36,000. So here the total is 1,69,200 and here 1,56,000 rupees. So remaining balance is 13,200. So closing stock as on the date of hire is 13,200. What is the salvage value is given? 3,600. So the claims to be made is 9,600. This is the problem. Is the gross profit is given on cost. For the previous problem, gross profit is given on sale. Okay, so for on sale you are directly taken 30%. Whereas in case of on cost, you are taking like this: cost plus profit equal to selling price. The cost is 100, on cost profit is 30%. So 30 rupees. So sales value is 130 rupees. So here the sales value is 1,36,000 is equal to 130, and you are calculating therefore for 30. It means the profit is 36,000. Okay. The next problem. In this problem, a fire occurred in the premises of Aruna & Co. on 1487, result in major destruction of stock from the following particular, ascertain the amount of claim. So here the purchases from 1187 to the date of hire is 2,10,000. Okay, 2,10,000 purchases, 2,10,000. The next sales from 1187 to up to the date of hire is 3,20,000. Wages paid 1187 to the date of hire is 15,000, but it includes 3,000 for installation of new machinery capital expenditure. So you have to exclude this 3,000 from 15,000 rupees capital expenditure. Exclude. The next closing stock as on 31st 12 1986. Okay, closing stock as on 31st 12 86. It means this is the opening stock value. The next carriage inward for the period from 1187 to 1187, 5,000 rupees. Carriage inward, it related to trading account, memorandum trading account. Okay, consider this one. The next carriage outward, it is related to profit and loss account. No need to consider this one, carriage outward. Okay, because it's related to profit and loss account. No need to consider this. Okay, the next gross profit ratio for the past 3 years, 20%, 25%, 24%. So previous problems, the gross profit ratio for the 1 year is given. Whereas in this problem, gross profit ratio for the past 3 years is given. Then you have to take the averages of these three gross profit. It means 20 plus 25 plus 24 divided by 3. You have to take average of gross profit. Okay. The next value of stock salvage is 600. The next insurance policy amount is 32,000. Okay. Policy insurance policy amount is 32,000. Average clause is applicable. Average clause is applicable. Average clause applicable. Here the insurance amount is 42,000 rupees. Average clause is applicable. It means your stock on the date of hire is more than the insurance amount. Okay, your stock on the date of hire is more than insurance amount. Then only average clause policy this will be applicable. Okay, let's see the problem. You can substitute the one by one. Purchases 2,10,000 rupees. Okay, purchases 2,10,000 rupees. Okay, sales up to the date of hire. Okay, sales up to the date of hire is 3,20,000. 3,20,000. Wages paid 15,000 rupees, but include capital expenditure. It means deduct the 15,000 rupees, the 3,000 rupees. Then the remaining is 12,000 rupees. The next closing stock of 31st 12 86, closing stock of 31st 12 86, it's nothing but opening stock for 1186. Okay, 60,000. Okay, 60,000. The next carriage inward. Okay, carriage inward is 5,000. Carriage inward is 5,000. Carriage inward is 5,000. Okay, now gross profit. Okay, gross profit is nothing but the averages of 20 plus 25 plus 24, okay, divided by 3 equal to 23%. Okay, 23%. Okay, so 23% on sale. So 3,20,000 multiplied by 23%, it comes to 73,600. Okay, now 360,600 is the debit side balance and 320 is the credit side balance. So remaining balance is 40,600. This is the closing stock on the date of fire. Okay, so here see, policy amount is 32,000 rupees. So what is the value of stock? 40,600. Okay, it means average class policy is applied in this problem because your insurance amount is less than the value of closing stock as on the date of fire. Okay, now what is the salvage value? 600 rupees. Salvage value is 600 rupees. Substitute the value 600. So your actual loss is 40,000 rupees. Now see, amount of claim is equal to, under average class policy, amount of policy divided by stock on the date of fire multiplied by actual loss of stock. So amount of policy is 32,000. Okay, stock on the date of fire is 40,600 and actual loss of stock is 40,000. So amount of claim is 31,527 rupees. Okay, so what we see, so here under loss of stock, GP ratio is given. Okay, in this method we see, and average class policy, this method also we see. In the next video, so we will see when gross profit ratio is not given. Okay, what we have to do in the next video, we will see this type of problem. Thank you for watching my video. Subscribe and share to your friends. Thank you.